Hello everyone, myself Pallavi Murulkar, I am corporate trainer. I have been in education industry from 2006. We are again here for the podcast program of Effective Life Management. So Dr. Rekha, I want to ask, what are causes of unwanted actions that make life ineffective, boring and meaningless?
Okay. See, when you talk about actions, it is always and necessarily something or a person does most of the times in response to something else. That means most of the times people are not acting, they're reacting. Remember, majority of our actions are reactions. And then we are reacting to something else. We are reacting that way because somebody or something has made us react in that way. So, the trigger of our action is somewhere else. The remote control of our action is somewhere else. Now, you say that some of our actions are meaningless, unwanted, and boring.
Correct.
Why? Because if we are acting, we will never ever do anything that is meaningless or boring or unwanted. We will only do the things which are wanted. Remember, a human being, or any living being for that matter, is a very selfish person. Whatever is going to give you benefit, profit, a person will do only that. If something is not going to give you any benefit, a person will never ever do any such thing on his own, unless something else is triggering that action. And so, we have to find out that something else. And most of the times, such causes, such things are so powerful and our conditioning has happened in such a way that we don't even realize the presence of those things. We take them for granted, and still their impact is so strong that we can't even evade the impact after knowing that this is not the thing which should influence. Still, it is not in the control of a person to evade that. So, when such triggers are around the person and a person is fully confused by various triggers, the person ends up in responding to two or more triggers at a time. And in that whole process, a person ends up in giving responses in the form of unwanted, meaningless actions that make the life ineffective and boring. I would like to give you a simple example. Suppose if you have a pet in your house, and the pet is like you're very much connected with the pet. The pet listens to you.
Good.
One fine day, a pet comes to you, trying to tell you, come, please take me out. And it is night time. Now, there are 2-3 people in the house. One person says, oh, you want to go out? Come, I will take you out. The fellow will immediately get up, and waiting for the person to get him a leash, to take him out. Yeah. Next moment, the other person shouts, "Is this a time to go out? Come on, hold on, stay properly." The fellow will keep quiet. Again, somebody will say, "Oh, you want to go out? Poor fellow, he wants to go out. Now let him." Again, he will be happy. Again, somebody will say. Now, all these are contradictory inputs. And at the end, the person will become totally confused. The pet becomes totally confused. And he will go on like looking at what to do, sitting properly. This kind of a situation, why I gave you the example of a pet, is because what happens with a pet in the house when you give contradictory inputs? Same thing happens to us when we get contradictory inputs. And when there are two, three sources or more than that kind of sources giving inputs to lead a person into various haywire directions, and a person respects all those sources, a person is confused. And the result of unwanted, meaningless actions that make a life boring is this kind of thing. So of course, in our effective life management program, we show this kind of source and we show you how much importance you should give to every source that makes you react. We make you understand the difference between action and reaction.
By remembering Newton's third law.
Yes.
For every reaction, there is equal and opposite reaction.
Right. Absolutely. Newton's third law. So that is how we generally react.
And so I think I remember one line also. It's related to, you can't be in a good book of everywhere.
Absolutely.
So because of this effective life management program, people can recognize which source he has to use.
Yes. Okay. Absolutely. See, because one has to always remember that there is a very vital fact, and that is, when people start criticizing you for some small and insignificant things that you do, understand that people have acknowledged your authority, goodness, and because they cannot be better than you, they are trying to criticize you. But of course, one should not think of it so blindly. One should definitely keep on introspecting. But that's a fact.
Well, very well explained by Dr. Rekha. And again, so how one can enroll for this program? For such a wonderful program.
Yes, sure. See, effective life management is definitely a life-changing program. I'm sure the viewers must have understood after hearing this small explanation that every class, people are going to get a new angle to life. And so, for this effective life management workshop, one can call up the number that is given below or fill up the form. The link is already given. Google form link is given. Fill up the form. And we will get back to you with all the further details about registration.